Hi, and welcome to Bauer Beauty, the channel where you will get professional skincare advice from me, a licensed esthetician, as well as stay on the leading edge of everything aesthetics. So make sure you subscribe right now and do like this video if you wind up liking it. That way it gets recommended to people who like things that you like. Now in this video today, I am talking about the top five best self-tanners of 2021 for pale skin. And pale skin, basically my tone, or lighter, or maybe even a little darker. But some of these self-tanners are quite light and natural, so they are great for pale skin. But some of them also give you a deep brown color very, very naturally. So it just kind of depends what you are interested in. I'm going to present this material starting from my least favorite to my most favorite, but these are all my favorites out of the dozens and dozens of self-tanners that I've tried throughout the years. I have tried so many, and so many have failed for me, and a few have succeeded, and these are the ones that have succeeded. And I'm going to present them to you in order from my least favorite to my most favorite. So make sure you watch till the end so you can see my analysis on my favorite self-tanner currently. The way I evaluated these self-tanners is based on the following criteria in order of most important to least important. Most importantly for me is ease of use. And what I mean by that is I can apply it, it's effortless, it's not going to grab onto dry skin and produce an uneven tan or patchiness. It is going to deposit color where I want it to deposit color without much manipulation and kind of effortlessly. AKA, you can just put it on and it looks amazing. You don't need to worry about manipulating it or coaxing it or doing the most to try to get it to look perfect. It's very easy to use. Secondly, most important to me is the tone and the depth. I don't mind whether it's more golden or more brown, but I prefer it to be a self-tanner that you can see a difference after one application. I don't like the self-tanners that are so light that you can barely even see any result. It's really important to me that I see the color develop within a few hours and there's a difference in my skin. Next is how it fades. How it fades is important to me because some of them fade really clunkily. They make a dramatic exit as they are leaving your skin. Things get patchy, things get dry, things get nasty. It looks like you have like just like freckles everywhere and your skin just looks like an uneven tone. It doesn't look tan. I really dislike self-tanners that get patchy as they peel off or as they flake off. I like a very natural fading effect. Next, it is ideal if it does not stain my sheets. I have white sheets, so it's a constant issue. If I'm using a self-tanner with a bronzer or a self-tanner that leaves my sheets discolored, I'm not a happy girl. I'm a very, very unhappy girl. Along with not staining the sheets, I also don't want it to stain my clothes because sometimes I put self-tanners on in the morning and I want to be able to put my clothes on and have it not transfer. Okay, and last but not least is smell. Pretty much most self-tanners have a smell, but I do like self-tanners that have more of a light smell if possible because of that same issue. I like to put self-tanners on in the morning sometimes. And you can't always do that if it smells really bad. So I'll indicate with each of these self-tanners what I think in that list of criteria, and I'll let you know the color and all of those details as well, so that you will be very informed by the end of this video about which self-tanners will be best for you. So don't forget to subscribe, like I said, and just keep watching. All of the products that are on my face, as well as all of my social media links to my products, are all in the description below. First product we're talking about today, I don't actually have on me. It is Saint-Tropez Self-Tan Classic Bronzing Mousse. This self-tanner was one of the first self-tanners that came out on the market that was prestige. This was the first self-tanning company that I remember that tried to innovate in the self-tanning market. Before this, most people in the 90s used drugstore self-tanners. L'Oreal, that's what I remember using. And this was the first prestige self-tanner, and it was amazing then. And it has held its amazing status until today, probably 20 years later. And what is great about this product is its ease of use. That is its strength. It goes on totally flawlessly. You don't have to be specific at all, and it just looks gorgeous. It develops beautifully. It is a more of a golden look versus a brown look, and it also isn't that dark. So for me, I do like one that's a little darker, but I would feel fully comfortable recommending this to basically anyone who has pale skin because of its ease of use. You can't really mess it up. It doesn't really stick to dry patches. It doesn't really get splotchy or streaky. It pretty much is just an even, beautiful, light glow. And if you're way paler than me, you might actually think that this is kind of a good darkness for you. But I do like something a little deeper. It does have a bronzer in it, so it can stain your sheets, and it also has that classic self-tanner smell. Moving into the next one, this is the Loving Tan Deluxe Bronzing Mousse. This is a very popular self-tanner social media. That's how I found out about it. I found out about it through influencers, and I tried it, and it's lovely. What I like about this is the ease of use is equally as good as the Saint-Tropez one, only this one is darker and it's more brown. One application of this and you look pretty brown. It's probably twice as dark as the Saint-Tropez one. It has a strong bronzer in it, which you can tell up top. It has a very strong bronzer in it. So yes, it will stain your sheets big time. Same with the Saint-Tropez one. You can't use these in the morning because, you know, they are going to deposit color on your clothing, and they do have that classic self-tanner aroma. But this also fades absolutely beautifully. If you just do one application, you will be perfectly fine. This fades without a trace. Ease of use, tone and depth, how it fades, stains, sheets, and smells. Okay, which brings me to my next one. The Tanologist Express Tan Foam in Medium. I love this product. Ease of use is there because I thought with a clear product, like, damn, I'm not even gonna be able to see where I'm putting this, and it's going to be patchy or streaky or something. I'm gonna miss a spot. But no, it was a flawless application. I've used it several times now, and it's been flawless every single time. Because it's totally clear, I can put it on before I go to bed, sleep in my beautiful white bed, and I don't have any stains in the morning. That is pretty amazing. Until I tried this product, I don't think that I experienced that. I think that most self-tanners that I have always used have had a bronzer or something in it that stains the sheets, and this one didn't. This is a little bit more golden with a dash of orange, but not orange in a bad way. I like the orange in it, but I would say it's more golden, warm versus brown. Actually takes a little while to develop, so I'm not sure why it's called Express. This to me, I actually like to apply 1, 2, or 3 days in a row to get it fully as deep as I want it to. It's almost like a gradual self-tanner. But if you prefer a lighter, more natural glow, one application, you will see a difference. And this is the medium. They have light, medium, dark, extra dark, I think. I would be happy to try the dark, actually, because that this is so flawless, and it's also a little bit light on me. Like, I do need more than one application. And the reason why I like this as well, the fact that it's clear, is because I can put this on in the morning. After I shower, I can put it right on. It's the most amazing thing. Put my clothes on, and go. It does have a little bit of a smell to it, but I just kind of deal with it. It's not horrible. It doesn't stain anything, and you can just watch your color develop throughout the day, and that's like super fun. Normally, you know, I've always done it where I go to bed with self-tanner on, I wake up in the morning and I'm tan, but with this, I've been doing it both ways because it is so easy to use and it's really, really nice. My second to last favorite, this is the Tan Luxe in light medium, and this is the one for the body. Almost 2 ounces, and this is the most expensive one of the group, I believe. Price-wise it is, I didn't break it down per ounce, but these drops, I'm a fan of drops like this because you can mix them in with your regular moisturizer and apply it. And the reason I like that is because with other self-tanners, you have to avoid putting moisturizer on before you put on self-tanner. So sometimes your skin gets dry. If you're using self-tanner multiple days in a row, your skin can dry out and that will actually lead to your self-tanner fading quicker. So I like these drops because you can add them to your regular moisturizer and then you're moisturized and tanned. I also like the ease of use of these is off the charts. My hands have never looked more effing flawless with any self-tanner ever. Period. This is probably like the most flawless, like I'm wearing it now, in terms of like the ease of the use. Like it's on par with the Saint-Tropez, and actually the tone is very similar to the Saint-Tropez as well. It's very golden bronze versus like a brown bronze. And like I said, this is the light medium, and I actually could probably get the medium dark because this isn't really dark enough for me. I'm wearing it now and not on my face though. And I would say this is like a little bit light, and I actually have applied it multiple days in a row, and it kind of maxes out at a certain deepness, and that deepness isn't very deep enough for me, but it is so natural and you still look like a golden tan, and it absolutely no streakiness, no patchiness. It doesn't stick to any dry areas of your skin. It's gorgeous. Really has no smell, which is kind of fascinating to me. So it's the one with the least amount of smell. I will say that for sure. So the way it fades too, it seems to be perfectly fine. The way that it's fading on me, I've just been using this for maybe like a month or so now, and I haven't noticed it fade in any bizarre ways. Yeah, I'm a fan of this, and I would feel comfortable recommending this to any single person. It's very easy to use and the result is very nice. Okay, last and not least at all, it's actually my favorite. This is the Isle of Paradise self-tanning drops for face and body in medium. I would say this is a good tone for me, but I would actually like to try the darker one as well. This is a brown result. You get a more brown result with this than you do with this. These are also drops that you add to your moisturizer, and the drops are nice too because you can kind of regulate how deep you want your color. So, you know, I pile it on and within a couple hours, I am brown. Brown, like significantly browner than I was before, probably on par with this Loving Tan. The only thing is I go through this really quickly, these 1 ounce bottles, like within 2 weeks, it's gone because I do use it almost every day too to maintain the tan. I just throw some in my moisturizer after I shower. This is another one that it's clear, it doesn't stain the sheets at all, but I typically don't put it on at night. I typically put it on in the morning. And the ease of use, it is pretty flawless, but it's not as great as this, like around the hands and the fingers and stuff. What I like about this one too is it is for the face and the body. So this is for the face and the body, whereas this one's just for the body. And that makes a difference, obviously, in the cost. So these are $29 for 1 ounce. And with the Tan Luxe, they have a separate face one. But what you could do is get the face one and use it on your face and body. And that one is $49 for 1 ounce versus $59 for almost 2 ounces of this one. So the body one's a little cheaper than the face one. But if you really wanted to stick with the Tan Luxe, you could get the face one and just use it on your face and body. Okay, an honorable mention, one that is good for the face that I've really been liking, is this Bondi Sands Pure Self-Tanning Drops. This is a liquid that you just add to your face moisturizer, and it is a very, very, very natural looking glow. And it also has no scent. Yeah, it doesn't have a scent, but it does smell a little bit like alcohol, but it doesn't have any added fragrance, which I love. And if you use enough, you see a difference in color after a few hours. This, however, doesn't last more than like 1 or 2 days after you wash your face at night. Pretty much it seems like it rinses off, but I still really like it because I feel comfortable adding it to my moisturizer in the morning, and it develops over the next few hours and it is a nice color. But I do see a way bigger difference for this one on the face. So like I said, this one is my favorite, and it really is just because of the color that you get. All of these are great with the application and how effortless they are to apply. So all of them are top notch in that regard, but this color is just the best. And it's also the type of tanning vehicle that I like. I prefer this tanning vehicle over this because this is like a full separate routine, whereas this you can just integrate into your everyday routine. You can just use these right out of the shower with your moisturizer, no big deal, versus this is like a whole separate show. And you guys know what I mean when you gotta like do the self-tanning routine versus just incorporating it into your daily routine. That's why I like these drops. As long as they work. I've used some that doesn't work as well. Let me know if you guys want like self-tanning video of self-tanners I hate, because there are actually a lot of them. So that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this. Hopefully it was helpful for you, and I'll see you in my next video. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel as well as like this video, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.